Good morning students, after the discussion of the Himalayan ranges, we'll talk with the next important physical division, that is the Northern Plains. See children, before talking about this, let's talk about India. India is rich in all the mineral resources, water resources, the good vegetation which is available and suitable for us. So as we know about the many diversities there, many resources are available, really we are very fortunate to live in India and have this great resources with us. Let's go with the Northern Plain of India. Children, before starting it, just make it clear about this, that the Northern Plain is very important and very important for our economic growth also. Northern Plain, as I told you, very important alluvial soil is present over there, which is really very helpful for a good production, and the surplus production we are able to export. So children, this is very important to look after the Northern Plains of India. Let's go. Northern Plain is located in the southern part of Himalayan ranges. As we discussed the three parallel ranges, the after parallel ranges, what is the next is Northern Plain. The if you look after, it has been formed by interplay of three major river systems are there. We are going to discuss the three major rivers which are very helpful for the formation of these Northern Plains. We'll talk about the three important rivers are Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. Along with their tributaries, it's very helpful for the formation of Northern Plain. And children, Northern Plain is also called as Indo-Gangetic Plain. Okay, this plain is formed of, I told you, alluvial soil is here, and children, alluvium was deposited by these three river system. Which three river system? Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. In the vast basin at the foothills of Himalaya, which we discussed in the previous video. Forming this fertile plain, and this is spread over an area of 7 lakh square kilometer. And the plain being about 2400 km long and 240 to 320 km broad. It is really very densely populated because many people are there, more than 85% of the Indian peoples, they are engaged in the occupation of agriculture. So this area is very densely populated. Physiographic division is letting you densely populated region. The material deposited by a river as its velocity reduces may create riverine island. Riverine island, have you heard about the island? Island which is surrounded by the water, but if see, that is the island like we are going to talk about Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar afterwards. But here they are talking about the riverine island. It means due to the water of river, the island formed. So riverine island, due to the deposition of huge quantity of silt, river split into numerous channels. These channels are called as distributaries. Okay, we will talk about in detail about this. See, I told you Indus, 1, 2, 3 rivers, Indus River, Ganga River and Brahmaputra River. The length 2400, breadth 240 to 320 kilometer varies, and the area covers 7 lakh square kilometer. Northern Plain is further divided into these three sections, Punjab Plain, Ganga Plain and Brahmaputra Plain. Children, first we'll talk about the Punjab Plain. Punjab Plain forms the western part of Northern Plain. This is formed by which river? Indus and its tributary like Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Peace and Satluj. If you remember, we read in the previous video, the group between from Indus to Satluj. A major portion of this plain is in Pakistan, and that is Dob. Dob, it means, if we'll divide this word, Dob means two and Ab means water. So it is of two water form, supported of two water formation abound in this plain. Next about the Punjab plain is Ganga plain. This plain extends between Ghagar to Tista. Okay, the previous video will help you in this to know about from Ghagar to Tista, even though in the textbook also it is given. Just go through with the textbook. From Ghagar to Tista, Ganga Plain, rivers are there. Ganga Plain, we are talking about the extent which is in between of Ghagar to Tista. The northern states, Haryana, Delhi, UP, Bihar and part of Jharkhand and West Bengal lies in this Ganga Plain. Next is about the Brahmaputra Plain. if you remember in the previous video I have shown you how it is moved towards the south. This plain formed the eastern part of Northern Plain, which is lies totally in the Assam. Hope the three division of Northern Plain is clear to you: Punjab Plain, Ganga Plain and Brahmaputra Plain. See this: Ganga Plain, Punjab Plain and Brahmaputra. First Punjab Plain, second Ganga Plain and third Brahmaputra Plain. Punjab. Now we will talk about the Punjab Plain. Punjab it means Panj plus Ab. It means the river of this Punjab is of, it's a merge of five rivers which are present in this: Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bees and Satluj. Ganga Plain, just I have shown you the picture, Ganga Plain from Ghagra to Tista. Then the next is Brahmaputra Plain, I told you, which lies in Assam. Now many people thinks about that the Northern Plain, it means a flat land. No children, it's not totally the flat land. Some of the, even in this plain area also, hills are there, mountains are there, plateaus are there. So we won't be able to go with this scenario is the Northern Plain is totally a flat land. Yes, somewhat the major portion, most probably major land, plain lands are there, but in that also we are able to get a diversity of different physical divisions. Let's talk about now how these divisions are there in this Northern Plain only. We'll talk about that based on the relief features. The Northern Plain can be divided into four regions. Four regions, it is very important to understand about these regions: Babar, Terai, Bhangar and Khadar. Let's talk about the first one. After descending from the mountain, the river deposited pebbles in the narrow belt. The width of this belt is varies from 8 to 16 km. It lies parallel to Shivalik. Children, it lies parallel to Shivalik. We are talking about southern part of Shivalik. This range is called as Babar, and all the streams disappears in this range. What it mean by disappear? It's not disappear. Actually, the river system covered with the pebbles, and we are able to see that here the river system from Shivalik, which descended towards the Northern Plain, when it enters in the Babar region, we says that all the river systems here disappear. But it's not disappear actually, it is covered with the pebbles which is not visible. So here it says that the river is disappear or the streams disappear. After Babar, we'll look after the Terai. Terai region lies towards the south of Babar belt. In this region, the streams reappear. Reappear means visible. And here we are able to see the river which is visible in this region, they are quite wet, swampy and marshy region. It means soil mixed with the water, that type of region. And this type of region is very helpful for agriculture. Next we'll talk about Bhangar. Bhangar is the largest part of Northern Plain and is composed of all old alluvium soil, best for agriculture. They lie above the floodplain, they resemble terraces. The soil of this region is locally known as kankar and is composed of calcareous deposit. It's very useful because kankar and the old alluvial soil, these mixture of soils are really well helpful for agriculture. After Bhangar, in Bhangar we are able to get the old alluvial soil, in Khadar we are able to get the new alluvial soil. Let's see. The floodplains formed by younger means the new alluviums are called Khadar. The soil in this region is renewed every year. Why it is renewed? Renew in the sense because of the river system which brings with them alluvial soils, and because of that it layers up the new again and again. Is thus highly fertile and very useful for agriculture. Hope you are clear about these four divisions: Babar, Terai, Bhangar and Khadar. Just look after in this map, you are able to clear about this. See the Babar, the narrow belt, then Terai, then Bhangar and then Khadar. As I told you, first one, it's a form of narrow belt with 18 to 16 km. As I told you, this here the streams disappear. Why? Because this region has more pebbles. Second one, Terai, with very water and soil is mix up, swampy, marshy lands are here. sterile, helpful for agriculture production. As I told you, bunga, old alluvial deposit is there, helpful again for agriculture, and khadar, which is new alluvial deposit, again helpful for the agriculture production. We discussed about the northern plain of India. Hope you have understood about the northern plains and of previous topic Himalayan ranges. If you have any doubt, you can concern to me and send me your queries to my WhatsApp. Thank you.